Good morning. Thank you so much, Starfish families and my whales families, for coming today for our drama presentation for the first grade. The first thing that I would like to tell you is I have to thank you so much for the amazing costumes that you made for your kids. That helps me out so much, and that's also a big part of our scenery. Once the kids are colorful and dressed up, it adds so much more to the drama of our story. Thank you very much for that. I appreciate your help. So, throughout the course of the year, the first grade and I have read and acted out many stories. A few months ago, we sat down, we talked about all of the stories that we read, and the first graders selected their favorite to perform for you today. And we have been working on these stories for almost 2 months now at this point. So they know them very well. The first performance will be by the Whales class, and they will be performing a favorite the world over that is called Where the Wild Things Are. And I have several narrators who will be helping me with the story. So, let's give them our attention. And, my wild things, are you ready? Yes. Narrators, are you ready?
Yes.
Starfish class, are you ready to be a good audience?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I see.
Okay.
A little technical difficulty, one moment, please.
And made them
sent the wild things up to bed without their supper.
And Max, the king of all wild things, said,
I wanted to be where someone loved them best of all.
Then all around from far away across the world,
they smell good things to eat. So Max said,
I'll give up being king of where the wild things are.
That's a good idea. Me.
But the wild thing cried. Roar, the treble roars.
Roar!
And gnash their turbo teeth.
And roar their turbo eyes.
And show their turbo claws.
But Max and Maxine stepped into their private boat and waved goodbye.
And they sailed back almost over a year.
And in an hour of weeks and 3 days.
And into the night of our own room.
Where they found their supper waiting for them.
Up to the clouds, but
but they were asleep.
Excuse me, clouds. Earth has no rain. Earth has no food. Earth asks for rain.
Then the bears went to find the wind, and the wind told them. Then the bats flew off to find the sun. When the bats got closer, the sun shouted.
So the sun burned down to heat up the earth. The steam rose up to the sky, the winds began to blow, and the clouds all gathered together. And the rain began to fall.
The savanna began to bloom and grow once again. Trees grew thick and tall, and their fruits and plants were soon ready for the harvest.
The birds were happy to see all of the wonderful fruits and the nectar in the plants that had grown for them to eat. They harvest and add until they were full.
Then the morning after the harvest, the birds prepare for the celebration. The bats remind them of the time.
But the birds were no longer in the mood for that kind of work.
We'll make the nest after.
that the birds didn't really mean it, and the bad news that they would never make the nest. Sadly, the bat was home. The sun went down, then the moon and the stars came out, and the celebration began.
All of the birds dancing and singing their wings. The drums playing their beats. The flute went into the night, and the birds dancing the night away.
The bats, tired and sad, went to sleep. Suddenly, the bats woke up in a panic. The moon and the stars had gone to bed. Slowly, the sun began to peek out on the horizon.
The birds tried to hide, but as the rays of the sun began to shine down on the trees, the bats were sure that the sun was looking for its nest. Scared because their promise had not been kept, the bats screamed.
And the bats went flying about the fort looking for a safe place to hide. As the bats flew, they found a cave and flew in to and stayed there.
The bats hid from the shame and embarrassment of not keeping the promise to the sun, a shame that the birds did not feel.
The celebration of the birds continued, but the bats remained safely in the cave. For many days and nights, the bats stayed hiding there. For many days and nights, the bats stayed hiding there and would only come out at night. Days and months and years went by, but the birds never left the nest. The sun never gave up hope.
Every day before it went down, the sun would take one last long look at the fort before showing it away to the horizon.
The sun does this even to this day, hoping that the birds would keep their promise and make the nest. The sun goes all over looking for its nest. The sun brings up steam so that the winds can blow and the clouds come together and the rain falls.
The bats make their home in the cave and live there to this day. Whenever the bats hear the rain, they wish they could come out and dance with magical sound. Then, the birds and the trees bow quietly to the bats as a thank you to the heroes who helped their land become green and beautiful once more.